Let me guess, you've heard about the vagus nerve. You understand that this 10th cranial nerve is largely responsible for your parasympathetic nervous system response, your rest and digest response, super important for managing stress and anxiety. You've probably also heard that breathing exercises are one of the most effective ways at home to predictably stimulate your vagus nerve. But then you do a little searching online and you find very, very different breathing practices. You see a lot of people doing things like this. Maybe you see some yoga students in white robes doing something like this. And then maybe you see people doing low, slow breathing that looks something like this. And you get really confused. Obviously, those are very different practices. They're going to affect your body and your nervous system and your vagus nerve, yes or no, very differently. And so what exactly do you do? If you're confused, this video is for you. Hey, my name's Lucas. I'm a yoga teacher. I'm a breathing coach. Breathing exercises have just exploded in popularity in recent years, which is amazing. Unfortunately, a lot of people are confused and they get a little mixed up. They do practices that stimulate your sympathetic nervous system right before bed, not the greatest idea. They do practices that put you to sleep first thing in the morning, again, not the greatest idea. With all the best of intentions, it's easy to get things flip-flopped. Hopefully this video will help set the record straight, help you understand specifically how to do breathing practices to stimulate your parasympathetic nervous system, to stimulate vagal tone, your vagus nerve response. In this video, we'll cover, number one, the biomechanics of breathing, how your diaphragm affects your heart, which communicates via your vagus nerve to your brain, how all that's connected. Number two, we'll talk about three breathing practices that are particularly helpful for your vagus nerve, ocean breathing, chin lock, and then the magical 1-to-2 ratio in terms of extending your exhale. And lastly, we'll do a stress-less breathing practice together. As usual, if you'd like to skip forward, there's a PDF down below. You can just grab that. Let's get started talking about the biomechanics of breathing and how this relates to your vagus nerve. Your primary breathing muscle is called your diaphragm, and it's an unusual muscle. It's shaped kind of like a plunger or a jellyfish. If you take two fingers and poke around underneath your bottom rib, your diaphragm is there, separating your upper and lower thoracic cavities. It's a skeletal muscle, so not so different than your biceps, but it's very strange in its function. When it's relaxed, it has this dome shape, this plunger shape. When it contracts, it flattens down. Your inhalation is actually where the muscle contraction happens. So your inhale is started by your diaphragm contracting and flattening down. That creates a vacuum that initiates the breath. How this relates to your vagus nerve is very interesting. Your diaphragm, in its relaxed position, it snuggles up against your heart and actually reduces the stroke volume. When you inhale deeply, 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 it creates extra intrathoracic space, and your heart volume, stroke volume, actually increases. And inside your heart, there are baroreceptors, like a barometer, baroreceptors. They sense pressure. And when they sense that pressure, they communicate, that pressure change, they communicate via your vagus nerve to your brain, and your brain then speeds up your heart. This is why, were you to inhale really quickly, your heart rate would speed up. Your vagus nerve is primarily a sensory nerve. It's also a motor nerve, but the majority of its function is actually sensing what's going on down here with a lot of your vital organs. So when it senses these pressure changes, it communicates to your brain. Your inhalation creates more space, more stroke volume, and a faster heartbeat. This is not wrong, but it's important to understand when you see somebody breathing short, shallow, high, focused on the inhales, that is not going to stimulate your vagus nerve. That is not going to stimulate a parasympathetic response, quite the opposite. Now, when we exhale, this is the weird thing, your exhale is passive, meaning your diaphragm, this muscle, it relaxes up and snuggles up into your heart, and it reduces the stroke volume, and again, those baroreceptors communicate via your vagus nerve to your brain to slow your heart down. How does all of this come to play with breathing? Essentially, the exhale is where the magic happens for slowing your heart. The exhale is where the magic happens for stimulating your parasympathetic nervous system response. And so when we spend more time exhaling, this is what we'll do, we spend more time stimulating our vagus nerve. Okay, let's look at three techniques that are really helpful for vagal nerve activation. When we're breathing, there's lots of different things that we can do. And these three practices, some of them might be really easy for you, some of them might not work for you. Don't think that you have to get all of them right, but if and when you can combine all three of these, it is a really potent recipe for self-soothing. The first one we'll look at is called ocean breathing. And ocean breathing is a yoga breathing technique. The classic name is Ujjayi breathing or victorious breathing. And it sounds like Darth Vader or a whisper sound in the back of your throat. I'll do it with my mouth open first, and then I'll show you with my mouth closed, which is how we traditionally practice. Now with my mouth closed. What this practice does is it oscillates or vibrates your vagus nerve, which runs down either side of your neck, and it helps to promote vagus nerve activation. Just like humming, chanting, singing, oming, any kind of campfire song, in the same way that feels good, that feels relaxing, this soft ocean breath, when you're doing breathing exercises designed to self-soothe, can be really, really effective. The next technique is called the chin lock, and this is a classic yoga technique called Jalandhara Bandha, which very few people are practicing these days, but it's very simple and really effective. How it works is at the top of the inhale, we'll close our nose and lock our chin to our chest. This chin lock, it compresses our vagus nerve gently and then releases. And again, this is for vagus nerve activation. I'll show you what it looks like. What this chin lock does, Jalandhara Bandha, again, it compresses and then releases your vagus nerve and can help amplify that rest, digest, relax response. The final technique, which is very, very important, is to double the length of your exhale. When we breathe slowly, specifically when we emphasize the exhale portion of the breath, that means our diaphragm spends more time relaxed, more time snuggled up against our heart. Those baroreceptors via our vagus nerve communicate to our brain to slow everything down. Were we to breathe short and shallow, our heart rate, when we exhale and spend extra time with that exhale, our heart rate slows, our parasympathetic nervous system is stimulated. These three techniques, ocean breath, chin lock, doubling the length of our exhale, these are really, really powerful techniques when combined, can have a very, very quick self-soothing effect to relieve stress and anxiety. And let's practice together. We'll do a practice here that's called stress-less breathing. Just a simple name I've given it. We'll inhale through our nose to the count of four, close our nose, lock our chin and hold for four, and then we'll exhale to the count of eight. As you'll notice, we're doubling the length of our exhale to spend more time with our diaphragm snuggled up against our heart. Let's practice together.
Stress-less breathing. Inhale through both nostrils, one, two, three, four. Close your nose, lock your chin, hold, one, two, three, four. Lift your chin, exhale, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Close your nose, lock your chin, hold, one, two, three, four. Lift your chin, exhale, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Close your nose, lock your chin, hold, one, two, three, four. Lift your chin, exhale, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Close your nose, lock your chin, one, two, three, four. Lift your chin, release, exhale, eight, seven, six, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Close your nose. Lock your chin. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lift your chin. Exhale 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Close your nose. Lock your chin. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lift your chin. Exhale 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Close your nose. Lock your chin. Hold 1, 2, 3, 4. Lift your chin. Exhale 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Close your nose. Lock your chin. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lift your chin. Exhale 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Close your nose. Lock your chin. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lift your chin. Exhale 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Final round. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Close your nose. Lock your chin. Hold 1, 2, 3, 4. Lift your chin. Exhale 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Eyes remain closed. Body relaxed. Breath is normal.
I hope you found that video helpful. Hopefully that gives you some insight in terms of how breathing exercises can impact your parasympathetic rest, digest, relax, stress response. If you'd like more science-based videos, please hit subscribe down below. I always love to hear from you in the comments section. Do grab that PDF down below in the description, and you can find my breathing courses and my teaching calendar at yogabody.com. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you in the next video.